opportunities. We are looking for people who are interested in partnering in some way in this journey. And that's it from my side.
Thank you. Thank you, Vivek. Now, may I request Mr. Anirban Ghosh, our last but not the least speaker. He's an electrical engineer from Jadavpur University. He's a marketing management from IIM Ahmedabad. He done a key role in the Chief Sustainability Officer of Mahindra Group. Your time starts now, Anirban.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. That this is an MSME conference, I would expect that most of you have units that would fall under that category. Let me begin by asking you a question. How many of you are in the supply chain of an automotive manufacturer? One and a half hands. Okay. So maybe this conversation will not worry you too much. Okay. One more question. How many of you are in the electricals and electronics industry? A few more hands. Good. One dominant conversation in the MSME space when it comes to electric vehicles is what will happen to the suppliers, because the number of moving parts in an electronic vehicle or electric vehicle will be much lesser than in an internal combustion engine vehicle. But I can see that question is not very important for this audience. However, opportunities that get thrown up because of moving towards an electric vehicle is something we should talk about. Yesterday, I was in the factory of a company called Mahindra Heavy Engines Private Limited. All they do is make engines. It's a fantastic factory. It was set up with the help of Navistar. And in the last 4 years, they have actually doubled energy productivity, which means that for the same amount of energy consumed in production, they now make two engines and not one. Those of you who run factories know that 60 to 70% of the variable cost of manufacturing is often energy. So if you double energy productivity, it is fantastic. But standing in that plant, the question that got asked was, you know, if everything moves towards electric vehicles, who will you make engines for? And that's a question that many MSMEs who make parts for engines, who make parts for an internal combustion engine and its various other drivetrains and everything else, ask themselves that what will happen if everything moves towards an electric vehicle? Well, the news is good and bad. Well, of course, there won't be internal combustion engines, but it's not as if it'll become zero, because while the cars become electric, while three-wheelers become electric, while two-wheelers become electric, we will see buses and trucks and heavy vehicles using internal combustion engines for some time. So disaster will not strike quickly. However, a lot of opportunities will open up, because in the electrical and electronic industry, the dominant part of that industry are all MSMEs, and I don't see how that is going to change. As an automotive manufacturer, I don't see us getting into manufacturing PCBs tomorrow. I don't see us getting into manufacturing electrical units like motors and, you know, various other electrical things that will go into the car tomorrow. We might have to do it in the short run, because the ecosystem may not be ready, but I don't see why that should be the story in the long run. So if we break up an electric vehicle, we will find that there will be electricals, there'll be electronic motors, there will be the suspension, the brakes, there will be body parts, and of course there will be the drive system. Now we know that the brakes will continue probably the way they are now, the drive system will continue probably the way they are now, though the transmission will completely go away, one expects everything to be automatic transmission. We know that the body parts will change because the vehicles will be lighter. The batteries themselves will provide a lot of the weight. And that's a question actually World Steel is asking itself, that if everything moves towards electric vehicles, will body parts move from steel to something else? And that's where MSMEs have another opportunity, because if it is to move towards composites, that again is an area where MSMEs are stronger than large organizations. In fact, the Mahindra Group has a small little company that makes composites. For the last 15 or 20 years, they've been hoping that the use of composites will grow miraculously in the economy. Maybe it will be the electric vehicles that will give these little units making composites a lease of life for the future. You've heard that Norway has a lot of electric vehicles. You've also heard that this has been possible because of the subsidies that were given. I must tell you a story. This was a platform where we were discussing electric vehicles and how it will go forward more than 4 or 5 years ago. And Norway had already made a lot of progress. So the gentleman who was from Norway was talking about the subsidies that the government offered the consumers to buy electric vehicles. When I heard the number, I realized that if we gave that subsidy to you, the Mahindra vehicle would come free. But that extent of subsidies we can't possibly expect in our country, nor should we expect subsidies in the future. I would think that in a span of 5 to 7 years' time, the need for subsidies would go away, because by then the cost of the battery will become such that the vehicle itself will start competing with internal combustion engine vehicles, and the electric vehicles that you will see on the road will be attractive enough for you to ask the question, should I not just buy the vehicle, and why worry whether it's being powered by batteries or whether it's being powered by petrol or diesel? The fact that operating costs will be very low will be an additional benefit for all of us. But at the end of the day, we will be buying very nice automobiles, much nicer than what we have available to us today. So the transition to electric will happen. There will be new opportunities for MSMEs. Question is, will MSMEs be ready to take them on? And since not many of you are here from the automobile supply chain, I will not get into what could be good strategy for you. But I will leave by painting a picture of what traffic could be like in the future by picking up on the threads which fellow panelists have already mentioned. You know that a perfectly well-behaved gentleman, the best way to get him to show his worst behavior is to put him behind the steering wheel of a car and let him loose on the streets of India. Because then suddenly we don't seem to care about anybody else. And I don't know whether rules and regulations will ever improve our traffic. Because if you've noticed in the last 4 or 5 years, we have a new epidemic of two-wheelers coming from the opposite direction. It's expanding to trucks on the highway, cars on slightly broader roads. So basically drivers are saying, if there is a road I will go, how does it matter which way I'm going? Now, the only way to get rid of it is to get drivers away from the steering wheel. And that can happen with a combination of electric vehicles and autonomous vehicles. So how will they run? So you keep hearing connected vehicles all the time. So while the vehicles will be able to talk to each other, it is not outrageous to think of an automotive system on the street which runs like the aircraft system in the skies or even the trains, where you will have central controlling units, you will have vehicles that can communicate, and you will say, okay, this is, I want to go from here to here, and you get directions on how to go, and all of it will be happening without human intervention. The only reason that won't happen to us in the next 10 or 15 years is we have lots of people who are employed as drivers. But the pressure of technology, the pressure of costs, and the pressure of preventing chaos on the streets will be so high that there will come a time when we will see vehicles moving on the streets in that way. So yes, electric vehicles will happen. Yes, there will be opportunities, but there will be transformation on the roads as well. And I hope some of us get to see it while we are still alive. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Anirban. Thank you for finishing on the time. I think if one or two questions, or we can finish here, they can do. I can. Thank you very much. I think one more session before lunch is there. And I thank all my speakers. Very good topics, very good also, you know, like content. But I had to cut short your timing because of paucity of time. What I heard from them, and you also heard, like main thing is the cost, weight, and the charging time. But I remember maybe the simile, what when that, you know, when he first had our, you know, that mobile, how heavy it was and how much time it used to take charge. The way it is going, I'm sure the time will come, a lot of research being done. You know, even that to computer, the way we have started, you know, Cardex, we used to give the Cardex, wait for this one. And the, you know, now these laptops are coming, that mainframe bit. I'm sure the good time will come again, and there will be a lot of good things in the vehicle. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time, audience.
Thank you, Mr. Sen. May I request Mr. Sen to present a token of appreciation to Mr. Vivek Chauhan, please. Thank you, Mr. Sen. May I request Mr. Sen to present... Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir. Mr. Sen to Mr. Anirban Ghosh, please. Thank you, Mr. Sen. Mr. Sen to... Sanjay Mukherjee, please. May I have it on the dais, Mr. Ardhindu Mondol, please. Sir, please. May I request Mr. Mondol to present a memento to Mr. P.K. Sen, our session moderator. With this, we close our panel discussion on EV vehicles. Now we go to the next session, which is our very interesting session on the affordable access to credit for the MSMEs. May I request on the dais of our session moderator, Mr. T.B. Chatterjee. I request all our delegates to remain seated for the next session.